Hey guys, let's hear Tushar's interview experience for Qualcomm. Tushar is a recent postgraduate from BITS Pilani in Communication Engineering. He got in Qualcomm through an off-campus drive.
Hello everyone, my name is Tushar Jain and I'm doing a master's in Communication Engineering in BITS Pilani. So today I'm here to share my interview experience in Qualcomm for modem engineer profile. So the process is like that. Firstly, I applied through off campus. I sent my resume to my friend who is working in the Qualcomm. So he gave me a refer. So then after the HR called me, and the first after resume selection, the first round was the telephonic interaction. Telephonic interaction around 10 to 15 minutes. After that, the HR called me and he fixed the date for the interview. So I think the telephonic interaction after 7 days, the interviews happen. And at the starting, there basically three technical round and one HR round for this process. So the first round was the telephonic interaction round. So in this part, it was the sudden round for me. They randomly called me and they tell that I'm from Qualcomm. And the first day they will ask you that is it right time to talk with you or not. So in my case, I was free at time. So I simply said, yes, you can talk with me. Otherwise, if you are not free or you are doing some work, you can tell him that we will discuss after 2 or 3 hours. So he will arrange that. So basically in the telephonic round, what they will ask, they ask mainly basis of your resume based question, your project based question, briefly describe your project. So you know that what you did in this project, and they ask the result, what you got in this project, what was the result of this project. So in the telephonic round, mainly the just thing to remember, you don't take the time for the answer. If they will ask, then don't take the 2 to 3 minutes to give the answer, because otherwise they thought that you are searching in the internet or no. So it may be rejected, you may be out for the process. So they just put the question, you instantly give the answer, whatever the question is there. And after that, they ask me some basic question like sampling theorem question, basic digital communication question, some Fourier transform, J-transform question. So he want to ensure that you are the right person or not. For my profile, the profile is related to the modem engineer. So he want to ensure that you are the communication engineer or not. So they will ask the basic question. So in my case, they ask me the sampling, what is the sampling and Nyquist criteria. They ask me digital communication, QPSK and COM modulation, and some question from my project. After telephonic round, I communicate with the company and they give me the schedule for the interview after 6 to 7 days. So at the day of the interview, there was mainly three technical round. So in the first technical round, they started with my resume. So I'm doing currently internship in Samsung R&D Bangalore. So firstly, they started with the question from my internship. Around 10 to 15 minutes, they focus on my internship. After that, they asked me, they started the question from analog communication. They asked me how to convert FM to PM and PM to FM, phase modulation to frequency modulation. Then we come to the signal processing part. In the signal processing, they asked me the FIR filter, IIR filter. They give me some waveform and they said if you do the up sample by 2 and down sample by 3, then what is the output of this waveform? And some sampling theorem question they asked. After that, they asked me the wireless communication question. This is the fixed question they ask generally in each and in every interview. What is the diversity? What is the MIMO? And how you differentiate between the diversity and MIMO? My profile is related to modem engineer. So it's related to more 4G and 5G. So then he started to asking the question from 4G and 5G. They asked me the basic core structure of the 4G, After that, like they asked me the protocol stack of 4G, and actually they asked me the like throughput calculation of 4G, like how you increase the data rate of 4G, and they give me the one scenario question, like if you have the 256 COM modulation, bandwidth is 20 megahertz and 4x4 memo layer, so what is the throughput of the 4G? So the something they want to like some asking the practical question also, because in when you calculate the throughput, some overhead problem is there, so you have to give the answer related to this. Then after, something is asking for the frame structure of the 4G and 5G. So the mainly my first round is going to the internship plus 4G related question. So after first round, my second round. The second round is also 45 to 50 minutes. So it was the continuous round, first, second, and third. So in the second round, they firstly started to my project. They spent the time 10 to 15 minutes on my project. They asked each and everything in my project, like why are you going like this approach for this project? What is the result you obtained? Then comparison between like, because one project is my related to the estimation theory. So he moved to the estimation part, like what is the MMAC, minimum mean square error, what is the LS, what is the MAC. So he come to the estimation part, like he give me one question, like how to estimate the channel, what are the basic condition to estimation the channel. Then he come to the some question related to OFDM. So the OFDM is very important topic for the modem engineer profile. For the communication interview. So he asked me the OFDM, like what is the OFDM, what is the drawback in the OFDM, in uplink and downlink, where we use the OFDM. So, he asked me the, like the block diagram of the OFDM, what are the steps involved in the OFDM. And then he asked me the cyclic prefix related question, if cyclic prefix is not there, like how it is happen. Then after he come to the my wireless communication profile, like my wireless communication questions. He asked me the time delay, delay spread, like Doppler spread. He asked me. He asked me like which fading is good, fast fading or slow fading, comparing between fast fading and slow fading, which one is good. Then after he come to the again he come my 4G part, like the most important question in the modem engineer, what I see it like the how UE is connected to eNode B. This is a very important question, because every interviewer is asked this question, how UE is connected to eNode B. So when you are going to the interview for the modem engineer, you are ensured that like this question is to prepare very well. So he asked me the how UE is connected to eNode B. So there are many many steps in between in the answer. So he asked me the each and every step, like what are the channel in the 4G, what are the logical channel, what are the physical channel, and he asked me the protocol stack layer by layer, by physical layer, transport layer, these things he will ask. Then after he asked me something related to the data rate related question. He asked me the power related question for in the 4G, how you control the power. Then something, because I in the resume I mentioned the RF microelectronics subject, so he asked me the RF microelectronic question, what are the LNA. He asked me the some construction part of the LNA, power amplifier. And I forget the most important question for the communication engineer, like communication block diagram. So he asked me the communication block diagram. So in the communication block diagram, you have to tell the each and everything. Like you have to tell the OFDM in it, the communication block diagram, estimation in the communication block diagram, and pre-coding, layer mapping, these blocks are introduced in the communication block diagram. So this will impact the good impression. Like you know each and everything. The interviewer thought that you know basics of the communication block diagram. So, and one more thing, he asked me the diversity and memo. So if he will ask the something related diversity and memo, so go to the basic of this, like how the diversity is induced, like introduce, how the diversity introduce, is just because the fading. So this thing, it will tell like, you know, the basic knowledge of the communication, like in the depth knowledge of the communication system. So this was my second round. Then after 10 to 15 minute I wait, and my manager round was called. The third round was the manager round. It's around to 10 to 15 minute. So the manager round was he's asking us some scenario based question. I was remember he asked me the one question, for example, if you have a coding rate R1 and the channel condition is bad, and coding rate R2 and channel condition is good. So compare between these coding rate, which one is higher and which one is lower, and why it is happening. So this is, he asked. One more question he asked, what is the difference between the correlation and convolution? And then he asked some repeated question, diversity and fading related question. So 10 to 15 minute it's going on. And some HR question he will ask, because this is the manager round. So there are some subject which is important for the communication interview. First one is the signal processing. In the signal processing, the filter part is very important, digital filter part, FIR, IIR filters, and analog filter is also important. Then you know the basic of sampling theorems, and this Fourier transform and Zener transform is also important, and upsample, downsample, like multi-rate signal processing is also important. So for the signal processing, I mainly go through the gate notes, because I prepare for the gate, so I have the notes. So mainly I follow the gate, my gate notes for the signal processing part. After that, the coding theory, the subject is coding theory. So coding theory is also very important subject. So in the coding theory, the random variable, random process is very important. And after random variable, random process, and channel coding, in the channel coding, convolution code is very important. In the convolution code, Viterbi decoding, mainly they will ask how you decode in the Viterbi decoding. So this is the topic in the coding theory. And in the RF microelectronics, for the subject of the RF microelectronics, the Rajavi book, which I refer for the RF microelectronics. So mainly three chapter is important. So one is the LNA part, one is the mixer part, and one is the common block diagram of the RF transmitter and receiver. So this is the important. And in the wireless communication, I think each and everything is important in wireless communication, but mainly they will focus on the diversity. They will focus on the OFDM. And the OFDM is very important topic. You know each and everything in OFDM. OFDM, if you know the OFDM, then you also understand the SCFDM. This is the in the drawback, the OFDM, then we resolve the drawback in the SCFDM. So SCFDM is very important. Then FDD, TDD, you know the difference between FDD and TDD. And the frame structure of the 3G and 4G in FDD and TDD. And in the wireless communication, fading, fast fading, slow fading, this is the important part. And these things is the important one. Yeah, TDMA, FDMA, CDMA, the modulation, multiple access technique of the TDMA, FDMA, SCFDMA, this is the very important. So for the wireless communication, I refer for the Jagannath sir video lecture on the YouTube. He's the professor of the IIT Kanpur. So these lectures are available in YouTube. So I refer the Jagannath sir video lecture. And estimation theory, I mainly focus my class notes, which is the class sir taught in my class. So I refer mainly estimation theory. In the estimation theory, they mainly focus on the minimum mean square error and how you estimate the channel, pilot symbols, these things they will ask. So these are the main topics. And one more thing I have to introduce, if they will ask some question, for example, communication block diagram, they will ask. So generally the people said basic block diagram, source coding, channel coding, then modulation, then channel decoding, source decoding, demodulation. This is the basic block diagram they will ask. But when the interviewer asks you the communication block diagram, so you tell the OFDM block in it also the communication block diagram, and the pre-coding, layer mapping. This is the very important two block introduced in the communication block diagram. So these thing impact that you know very depth knowledge in a communication. So it will impact the very good impression for the interview. So these thing like I refer for the digital communication and signal processing and coding theory, information theory, I refer my GATE notes. And for wireless communication, I refer for the Jagannath sir video lecture, which is available on YouTube. For the RF microelectronic, the Baird Rajavi book is available in online open source, so I refer for this. And estimation theory, I refer my class notes